आरडी शर्मा सॉल्यूशंस वी आर टेकिंग, दिस इज क्लास 10 मैथ्स, चैप्टर 7 स्टैटिस्टिक्स, एक्सरसाइज इज 7.2। द क्वेश्चन इज बेस्ड ऑन वी हैव टू फाइंड द मीन। नाउ देयर आर वेरियस वे इन विच वी कैन फाइंड द मीन, इट डिपेंड्स ऑन व्हाट इज द ऑब्जर्वेशन, हाउ मेनी ऑब्जर्वेशंस आर देयर, दैट इज the frequency, the actual number. So what we have seen in the earlier discussion was, when we found mean, it was simply sigma fi xi by sigma f. That means if we have the observation, that is these are the numbers, and we have how many times these numbers have, these events have occurred, this is the frequency. So we just multiply these two like this till here, and we added. So we call them as sigma fi xi. Then we added this whole from here to here, and this is sigma f. We divided and that was the mean. But here, in many cases, it may happen. For example, if you write this number of calls and number of intervals. The question is number of telephone calls received at an exchange per interval for 250 successive 1 minute interval are given like this. That means the number of calls are 2 if the number of intervals, for number of intervals 29, for 3 it is 46. That means that this is the number of calls, which is our x, and this is our number of intervals, that is our frequency. So this is given. But in many cases these numbers are very very small, but in many cases these numbers can be very large, say 1782. Okay, how you are going to multiply this number with this number, that is sigma fi, this fi xi you have to do. For this we need some other way to solve it. I'll come up with, there is one question which has a quite bigger number, but this is just for understanding that this is our xi. We'll write this in one column. Then we have fi. This xi just means that x is the number, I varies from 1 to how many numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7. So x1 to x7 we have. Then from this frequency, this is f1. And this is F7, like this we have. So what we will do here is, we will try to assume a mean. If we have to decrease the computation, the complexity, we will assume by ourselves a mean in the beginning itself. So what we can do here is, this is the whole value of x. Let us come to the center one, that is the middle one. You can take this also, it doesn't matter. But it is always advised to take the central one. Now this is 3. What we will do here is, we will subtract all these elements with this 3. So 0 minus 3, what is this? Minus 3. 1 minus 3, it is minus 2. 2 minus 3, it is minus 1. 3 minus 3, it is 0. 4 minus 3, it is 1. 5 minus 3, it is 2. And 6 minus 3, it is 3. So now we will not deal with this anymore. We will deal with now this one, which we found out as subtracting each and every element from the assumed mean. This the mean we have assumed. Now this remains the same fi frequency. So now we will multiply the same sigma fi xi. Now we'll multiply fi and ui. This is ui. So now 15 into minus 3 minus 45, 24 into minus 2, then 29 into minus 1, then 0, like this. So this is minus 29. 54 into 1 and 43 into 2 and 39 into 3, all these will come here. Now we will add all these. Okay, all of these we add. This is the sum. So now this is sigma fi ui, that is 135 in this case. Now we'll add all these, that is frequency we have to add. In the previous way also we added this. So now this is 250. Sigma f is 250. Now, in previous discussions, we have seen that this number is the solution. This is the mean. But here, because we have assumed a mean, which is 3, so we have to add this 3 to this answer. So 3 plus 135 plus by 250, this is our answer, which will come to be 3.54. So I hope you got the idea. Now we'll do it directly. I hope you understood what we have been doing. So 5 coins are simultaneously tossed 1000 times, and at each toss the number of heads were observed. The number of tosses during this during which this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 heads were obtained are shown in the table below. Find the mean number of heads per toss. So here we'll write xi, here fi. Then we'll find, we'll assume this to be the mean, that is 2. So this 0 minus 2, 1 minus 2, like this. This value we'll find. Then we'll multiply these two, these two, these two, these two, these two, these two, write it here. We'll add all of these, that is 470. And 470 by 1000 is what we can get. And then we have assumed a mean, which is 2. So we have to add a 2 also here. This will come as 2.47. Next one, the following table gives the number of branches and number of plants in the garden of a school. So these are the number of branches, we'll take it as x, and number of plants as f. Calculate the average number of branches per plant. So we have xi, fi, we'll write it here. Now we'll assume a mean as 4. We'll subtract each and every number of this column with 4, we'll write it here. Then we'll multiply these two, these two, these two, these two, these two. We'll write it here. We'll add all of these. That will be minus 77. So minus 77 is sigma fi ui. And your capital N is 200. Right? 200. And we have assumed the mean to be 4. So we will add it. 4 minus 77 by 200. That will be your 3.615. The following table gives the number of children of 150 families in a village. So we'll write the number of children, we'll write the number of families here, and then we'll assume the mean to be 2. So 2, the value of 2 is not here, so we'll write 2 here, 255, and then when we subtract, we assume mean to be 2, so 2 minus 2 is 0, this will be 0. And now we'll multiply all these. We'll subtract first minus 2 because the assumed mean is minus 2, minus 2, minus 2. This will come. We'll multiply each and every term. So we'll get 55 into 0, like 0 here. Now we'll add all these because we have multiplied these corresponding terms. And then we have to add. This is 52. Now 52 divided by this whole number, when you add this, this is going to come as 150, not 20. 150. What was the assumed mean? Assumed mean is 2. So we'll add 2 with this. This is our answer. 2.35 will come. The marks obtained out of 50 by 102 students in a physics test are given in the frequency table below. These are marks and these are the frequency. Now we have to find the average number of marks. What we'll do here is, we'll do the same thing. First, we are going to make a table, and this table is very important. This table, xi, all these, then fi. Then we will assume the mean to be what? We'll assume the mean, let us go to the center one, 25. We'll assume the mean to be 25. Now 15 minus 25, this is minus 10, like this, all, you know, you have to subtract every element with 25 and this will come. Now you multiply these corresponding terms, fi and ui, you'll get this one. Then you add this, you'll get 110, all these. So 110, and what is the total student number, 102? So this is 102. 102. So this is 102, and what was the assumed mean? It was 25. You have to add this. So this will come as 26.08. The number of students absent in a class was recorded every day for 120 days, and the information is given below like this. Number of students absent and number of days. We have to find the mean number of the students absent per day. So here is xi, that is this line. Here is fi, that is this line. And we have assumed mean as 3. So subtract each and every term, this is 0. Subtract each term by this 3, okay, all of these, you'll get this line, this column. Now here you have number of days and you have ui, you just multiply each of these and you get fi ui. So when you have fi ui, this, when you add this, it is going to come as 63, and this is given as 120. Assume mean was 3, so just add 3 here. So what do you get? 3.53. In the first proof of reading of a book containing 300 pages, the following distribution of misprints was obtained. Number of misprints per page is these, and number of pages are these. Find the average number of misprints per page. So here we have number of misprints, you have number of days, and then you just take this 3 as the 3, or you can take 2 also. Let us take 2. 2 as the assumed mean. So this will be 2. We are taking 2 as the assumed mean. Now subtract each and every element by 2. You get this line. Now multiply this line with this line, each and every element, like 154 with minus 2, each and every, that is corresponding element, not each and every, that is 154 with minus 2, 95 with minus 1, like this. So you get a line here. You add all of these. This is sigma fi ui. So this will be 381. What is sigma f? This is 300. And what assumed mean was 2. So you add 2 here. But you see, this is not 381. The number is higher. So this is minus 381. So this will be minus 381. Okay, 2 minus 381 by 300. That will be 0.73. The distribution gives the number of accidents met by 160 workers in a factory during a month. Number of accident is there, number of workers are there. Find the average number of accident per worker. So here you have number of accidents, you have number of workers. We are assuming the mean to be 2 now. Assuming mean, so this is 2. So we'll subtract each and every term in this column by 2. You'll get this line, this column. And we already have this frequency. So now multiply 70 with minus 2, 52 with minus 1, 34 with 0, 3 with 1, and 2 with 2, 1 with 2. So you get this column. Now add all these elements of this column. You get minus 187. So minus 187 is sigma fi ui. And sigma f is what? This is 100. And what is your assumed mean? It was 2. So just add 2 here. 2 minus 187 by 160. This is going to be 0.83. Now we have to find the mean from the following frequency distribution of marks at a test in statistics. Here if you see, when I started this discussion, when we started these problems, I told you that when this xi is a large number or you know, comparatively large number, the multiplication of these two columns will be quite means complex. Computation will be complex. It will take a lot of time. In order to get rid of that, we follow this kind of procedure where we assume a mean. So this is a classic example of that. So we will assume the mean to be 25. Assume mean. So this will be 25. So we subtract each element of this column by 25. All 25. You get this line. Now you have frequency as this one. Now multiply 15 with minus 20, you get this one. So all these corresponding element or value of these two columns have to be multiplied. Now you add all these. You get minus 1170. 1 minus 1170 is sigma fi ui. This is what you get. Now here, sigma fi ui is this one. When you add this fi, sigma fi, this is 400. What was the assumed mean? It was 25. So 25 minus 1170 by 400 is 22.075. So these were the question where we tried to get mean using the assumed mean. And when do we employ this? When we have the observation xi as large number. So we don't want to multiply and make the things complex. We just try to make it easier so that the computation is easy. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.